musicians and singers particularly are really good examples. They don't give up, do they? You know, Queen, Mick Jagger, they're just going on another tour, and they're all in their late 60s.
As our population continues to age, many people wonder how long they will want to or have to work. How this will play out, however, is still largely an unanswered question. In a collaborative project, the European Policy Center and the Bertelsmann Foundation wanted to find out what would have to be done in order to give older people a better chance on the job market. In an era where Europe is actively aging and there is solidarity between generations, the project partners pursued the answer to this question with the help of experts in science and politics, the social sector, and business.
Well, it might sound silly because we live in a time of youth unemployment. On the other hand, we see that in Europe, all the pension systems have been reformed. We have to work longer, and that's also good news because we can live longer. But if we do not invest in what kind of work people could do and how people could be happy to work longer, then the whole reform will be in vain. And that's why last year, by the end of 2011, we took up this project and see what we got in 1 year.
In the work we've done on this, we've been very careful to try to avoid making a direct competition. We've been trying to look for what are the characteristics of people over pension age, what is it they actually can do, what is it that they can do that is separate from what is in the rest of the labor market. But again and again, I need to say, this is not about sharing jobs. This is about creating a dynamic economy that could benefit all categories, all cohorts of our population.
The results of this project reveal there's no universal solution for all of the member states of the EU. Just as the problems in Europe are different, so too are the reasons and wishes that older generations have as they continue to be members of the workforce. The coastal resort of Brighton in southern England. An ideal place to peacefully spend one's retirement? Over 40 years ago, Penelope Young's career in radio journalism began with her first job with the BBC. Today, she's 68 and doesn't even think about quitting. At age 64, she changed her life for the third time. She began writing and passed on her experience of aging to others. In addition, she consults with people over 50 who are pursuing a second career.
We are more active, more energetic, healthier in our 50s, 60s, and 70s than our parents were. And so we have a huge amount to give back to society. And to retire, what does that say? Does it say, I'm at the end of my productive life, so now I sit here and watch television for the next 30 years? That sounds like not a very good deal to me.
The western German town of Mettmann, near Düsseldorf, used to be an important center of the cutlery industry. The German Federal Employment Agency now runs an education and conference center here. Their seminars are not just about the world of work, but what comes afterwards. Seminar leader Christian Kautz was already in early retirement when his employer offered him the opportunity to run seminars because of his 40 years of work experience. It's a smooth transition for me. I remain in contact with former colleagues to keep up on things a bit. Two or three times per month, this retiree passes on his experiences through these management seminars, earns a little bit of extra income, and benefits his own personal growth as well. I think I'm getting better at the seminars, there's no doubt. That has to do with the amount of time, and I approach it a bit more relaxed than in the past. It's happened sometimes that I myself had the feeling I was going there not very well prepared. I don't have this feeling anymore in retirement. In the Austrian Alps, agriculture has always been very important. The farming lifestyle is deeply embedded in its towns and suburban areas. Today, tourism is the main source of income here. For the past three generations, the Ganner family has housed vacationers on its expansive farm. Johann Ganner Sr. takes care of the vacation homes and farming, and in doing so, he relieves the other family members who do their share of hard work. In the Ganner family, it goes without saying that three generations work under one roof. It's the only way for the family business to have a future. In the meantime, I've handed over the farm and the guest house to my son. But from the bottom of my heart, I am still closely connected to our farm and area. It's really a family business. You have to change with the times. Farming needs to be simplified a bit. Previously, farming was number one, then came forestry, and third was tourism. Today, it's reversed. The son's full-time job down in the valley gives the family economic security. However, to make ends meet, the family cannot give up its work in agriculture and vacation homes. That's why Johann Ganner still supports his son as best he can, despite his age. These examples show only a few of the pressing challenges which older people face as they continue to be part of the workforce. At the conclusion of the project, the final conference revolved around the question of the part politics, the social sector, and businesses, as well as individuals themselves, can play in improving the job prospects of older workers.
We should see this as a more long-term challenge. We have time to adjust, but we need to be very focused when adjusting and innovating. The question of aging, the demographic transformation, applies in all member states, and we have to continue this work together within the context of the European year, even after it concludes, and together with the stakeholders.
Which labor market would that be?
People no longer think about their working career as having one single employer until they retire.
I think the whole debate is when is it compulsory or not to retire? And at what age you can have your full pension? It has to
do as well with older workers don't just voice problems, they also offer solutions, which can be adopted by politicians. Brighton, the city on the English Channel, attracts primarily young people who want to improve their English at one of the language schools. Discovering new horizons, that's something the older generation here in Brighton Hove wants to do as well. Earlier in life, Chris Gull worked as a dentist. Today, the 61-year-old sells pastry and snacks in his own cafe. A few years ago, he gave up his dental practice and used his savings to start something new. He knows that's not something everyone can do.
Pension age is going to be increased. Probably the amount of pension relative to what we were earning is going to go down. So I think there's going to be strong motivation for us to keep working. But I think that's also a good thing. My experience is people who keep an interest and keep working or have very strong hobbies or do voluntary work live longer, happier, more useful lives, I think. A scenario where people are forced to work and stay in jobs that they're not enjoying, where their work-life balance isn't good, and that clearly needs to be appreciated and looked at, because it is possible to have the best of both worlds on there, and maybe use that time rather than saying, right, you've got to keep working until you're 70 and stay where you are. Actually probably encourage people to make a shift, make a change, maybe work part-time rather than full-time, that they're supporting the younger generations and the rest of the community rather than being forced into a hole and being told just to to keep on working and keep your nose to the grindstone.
First impressions are deceptive. Even in sunny Italy, older workers worry. Just under 11% of the population is unemployed. Many of them are over 40. Once a lawyer, Walter Deitinger had to start a new career at the beginning of his 50s. Ever since, he's spent his free time volunteering for ADTAL 40, a lobby group for older unemployed workers in Italy, making sure their concerns are being heard in public.
Io penso che il governo, I partiti,
the unemployment of senior citizens hasn't got the highest priority in government and politics or unions. They've got other preferences.
Una parte molto importante. L'Italia deve diventare più aperta, più sensibile.
Italy should open up more. It should recognize the value of the performance of everyone for the society. And when I say everyone, I mean young people, old people, women, men, immigrants, all Italian citizens.
Donne, uomini. Migranti, cittadini italiani.
This opinion is also shared by the Italian Minister for Employment.
To have a better recovery, we need the work of all working group in the population. So we need to have women to work, we need to have the young to work, and also the elderly. I know that to say this in a recession is it seems just like nonsense, but it is not.
We see really now a majority of retired people who would like either to come back or to have been able to continue, and this is where we need to think about innovative ways to accommodate all this goodwill. We are all conscious that we will need to work for longer if we want to save our social system and if we want to ensure a fairer future for the younger generations.
It's a very appropriate debate and a very timely contribution from the European Policy Center and the Bertelsmann Stiftung, and we are having glad to contribute to that debate as well.
There might be some ideas about being flexible and have the necessary security and combine it also with a kind of an active labour market policy for both the young and the older.
You also need professionalities, all these kind of things that you don't build in one day, not even in one year. So you need to work. Youth unemployment before the pension, no, we didn't have that choice.
So all these policy context, so to say, should be put in place to, in order to, keep these elder people, and I'm speaking now about, well, maybe the people between 50 and 70, in generally, happily in the labor market.